and those who are above in that great cloud of witnesses. Looking down on this faith journey, their two paths will now merge into one as their marriage represents a great mystery. It is the mystery of Christ and his church. It is our prayer that as they take on this path, that they will constantly recognize God's divine presence and constantly seek his divine power. God bless you.
Can y'all hear me? We're going to say, come. Come. All are welcome to celebrate what God has done. Come one, come all. Come young, come old, come rich, come poor. Come friend, come neighbor, come stranger, come friend. Come see what the Lord has done. Soon, two will become one. It is the Lord's doing, and it is marvelous in our sight. We are ready to celebrate.
Praise the Lord. Woo. Hallelujah.
Now this is a celebration, so y'all can put your hands together and clap along with us. Come on, put your hands together. Come on, come on. I don't see everybody clapping. Put them hands together. Come on, come on.
Lord, you are good and your mercy endureth forever. You are good and your mercy endureth forever. Lord, you are good and your mercy endureth forever. Lord, you are good and your mercy endureth forever. People from every nation and tongue, from generation to
and tongue, from generation.
can testify to it, why don't you just wave your hand and tell the Lord, you've been real good
to me.
My life, God, you've been so good. All of my life, you've been faithful, so good. Whoop. God, I bless your mighty name, Jesus. You've been
so good.
Bless your mighty name, God. Wonderful Jesus, so good, so good to me.
You are.
Right there. Hallelujah. Wonderful Jesus.
No one could have told either one of us that we would be right here, right now. I mean, it started off in the most unusual circumstances. Nobody goes into a pandemic thinking that they will meet their mate, but that's what happened. And well, it took both of us getting out of our comfort zone to take a chance on something unfamiliar, but it really paid off. And it was more than a profile, a click, a like, and a heart. It was God doing something to draw us together. And there's purpose in this. We knew it from the start. I mean, from the very beginning, our first conversation was so free and easy. And then we just kept talking and adding to that laughter and prayer. And we knew something special was happening. So we've been dancing this divine, beautiful salsa, having fun in a whole new way of life for both of us. So we committed to continue growing in love, and that's what got us here today. And now we're ready. We're ready to tell the world and to make it last forever. This commitment to continue growing in love. And of course, dancing and having a good time. Yep, we're ready.
midnight, they heard the sound. The call rang out that the bridegroom was near. As they rushed to trim their lamps, the foolish virgins did not have enough oil to go out and greet him. When he arrived, they were not ready, but those wise virgins who had extra oil with them were ready to go with him. The time to prepare is now. We do not know the day or hour when he will return. May our lamps remain filled with oil and our lights ever shine until he calls us to be with him. Soon the one we waited for will return and we must be ready.
like the roar of rushing waters and like loud peals of thunder shouting, Hallelujah, for our Lord God Almighty reigns. Let us rejoice and be glad and give him glory, for the wedding of the Lamb has come and his bride has made herself ready. Fine linen, bright and clean, was given her to wear. Fine linen stands for the righteous acts of the saints.
Talking about ready and everything tonight. But I'll tell you when it's time. You just be ready. What a joy it is for us to be here tonight. What a delight it is for us to join in the celebration of the union of these two individuals. What an experience already. Intentionally, these individuals have chosen that we would gather together in a worship setting to bless the Lord for what the Lord has done by bringing the two of them together and now preparing for them to enter into a holy wedlock that shall unite them and keep them together until death shall part them. And we're grateful that we've been given the opportunity to be here with them, aren't we? We celebrate with them. We are excited that God has given to them this 11th day of the 11th month of the 22nd year of this century. To God be the glory for 11-11-22, for Ree and for Lakeisha. Let's give God praise for this union. To God be the glory. While you're still standing, let's pray. Gracious God, how we give you the glory that is due unto your name. How we honor and magnify you for your goodness and your grace toward us. We honor you this Friday evening, for you have given to us the privilege to gather together in this sanctuary, made holy by your very presence. And we thank you that in your presence there is fullness of joy. And we feel that joy even now. Thank you, great God, that you still bring together man and woman, husband and wife, that they might live together in unity for a lifetime. And we do now pray for these who come together in this sacred space to join their hands, their hearts, in their home one with another, so that you might be glorified through their lives and that people might see in them an example of godly marriage. We pray now your blessings upon us. We pray that your presence will be in this place, or we might experience you even as we celebrate what you have done for these two individuals. We give you great praise because you are great God. In the strong and precious name of our great Savior, we pray with great thanksgiving and great expectation. And let all God's people together say amen.
Amen.
Amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. My dearly beloved, we've gathered in this place to share in the joyous union of this man and this woman in holy matrimony, which is commended by St. Paul to be honorable among all people, and therefore is not to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, discreetly, advisedly, and in the fear of God. Into this joyous union, these two persons present come now to be joined. Who gives this woman to be married to this man? Thank you, sir. God bless you. Now you know. My goodness. Please come this way. Praise the Lord. What a joy. By the very fact that you received invitation to come to this place means that you mean something special to Ree and Keisha. Their lives are examples of love and fellowship and friendship, family. And so in this place now are friends and family, loved ones who gather with them. The Lord Jesus blessed a wedding at Cana in Galilee with his very presence. And his presence is in this place right now to bless this union, this experience. And we're so grateful that he has come among us and we are ready to receive him as he is our King of glory forever and forever. How we honor him tonight, how we celebrate him, how we give glory to him. When you're in the presence of a king, you ought to know how to respond, how to act, how to react. So we bow down before the King of glory and we magnify his holy name. Tonight, as we share together, I'm excited that we have the opportunity to give witness to what these two individuals have pledged one to another in private and now do so in public. Ree, will you have this woman to be your lawfully wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you love her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only unto her as long as you both shall live? If so, answer, I will. Thank you, sir. She just said, good. Lakeisha, will you have this man to be your lawfully wedded husband, to live together after God's holy ordinance in the estate of matrimony? Will you love him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only unto him, as long as you both shall live? If so, answer, I will. Thank you, ma'am. She didn't look at you. Oh, okay. There you go. Say good. Say good. Good. There you go. Will you now both mutually promise in the presence of God and these witnesses that you will at all times and in all circumstances conduct yourselves as becometh husband and wife? If so, answer, we will. Thank you very much. Praise the Lord for that. Will you now join your right hands and repeat after me? I, Ree, take you, Lakeisha.
Take you, Lakeisha.
To be my lawfully wedded wife.
To be my lawfully wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better and for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death.
Yes, sir.
Do us part.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. According to God's.
According to God.
Holy ordinance.
Holy ordinance.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, sir. Amen. Lakeisha, will you repeat after me? I, Lakeisha.
I, Lakeisha.
Take you, Ree.
take you, Re.
To my lawfully wedded husband.
To my lawfully wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death. Do us part.
According to God's.
According to God's.
Holy ordinance.
Holy ordinance.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Are there rings? Are there rings? Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, my Lord. Beautiful rings they are. The ring is a circle. It is the emblem of eternity. It is to show how lasting and imperishable the love that you now mutually pledge really is. As the union that is now formed is to be sundered only by death, it behooves you to understand the duties that you now solemnly assume. For if these duties be faithfully discharged, they will add to the blessedness of this life. But if these duties be neglected and violated, you cannot escape the keenest misery, as well as the most horrible guilt. Read, it is the duty of the husband to provide for the support of his wife, to cherish for her a manly and unalterable affection, to remember that God's word says that husbands must love their wives, even as Christ loved the church and gave his life for her. Lakeisha, it is the duty of the wife to reverence her husband and to put on the ornament of a meek spirit, which is, in God's sight, an ornament of great price, it being the command of God's word that wives be subject unto their own husbands, even as the church is subject unto Christ. It is the duty of you both to delight each in the society of the other, to remember that in interest, as well as in affection and reputation, you are to be henceforth one and undivided, to cherish an undying fidelity, and see to it that what God joins together, human beings never put asunder. Let's pray together. Gracious God, we do thank you for these symbols, these rings with no beginning, no ending, no brokenness. I thank you that what these two individuals engage now is that which will bind them together, even as these rings serve as shackles reminding them of the binding one to another in which they are engaged tonight. I pray now that as each gives and receives these rings, they will remember the love that they have for one another at this very moment, and that that love will only blossom and deepen and mature as the years continue to pass. We pray now your blessings upon these symbols and upon the ones who will give and receive them in Jesus' name. Amen. Reed, will you take all this bling and place it on the left ring finger of your bride and repeat after me? Look at her, look at her. As a pledge and in token
and in token
of the vows
between us made
with this ring
I thee wed
in the name of the Father
and of the Son
and of the Holy Ghost
amen.
Keisha, will you take this ring and place it on the left ring finger of your groom and repeat after me? As a pledge
and in token
of the vows
between us made
with this ring
I thee wed
in the name of the Father
and of the Son
and of the Holy Ghost
amen.
Praise the Lord. Three very special women have been chosen to share with us more symbols. You'll see symbols all about us tonight. Symbols of rings being exchanged, symbols of loved ones flanking the bride and the groom, symbols of light being carried into this room. We've seen symbols all about us, and more shall be shown even now as three women of God come forward to share with us a unity ceremony, reminding us that where the Lord sees unity, the Bible says he commands a blessing. And so we pray God's blessings upon this marriage of unity. Pastor Palmer.
Have been brought together by God from two different worlds. The blended sands represent the pouring of themselves into this covenant of marriage. They will become one, never losing their unique identity, but becoming united in hopes, dreams, and purpose of God.
In Spanish language, when a woman gives birth, one of the expressions used is dar la luz, which literally translates as to give the light. Rhea and Lakeisha were born into this world and then born again in Christ to be the light of the world. And now their lights will become united in holy matrimony to shine for God's glory.
Amen, amen.
God is love.
Yeah.
God demonstrated love through sacrifice and faithfulness. Rhea and Lakeisha are committed to continue growing in love as they demonstrate the heart of God in marriage. The crystal pin represents the pure love of God that will keep their bond of love as they become one.
Don't do that. Don't do that now. Yes, ma'am. Okay. I'm going to ask that you will go now to that symbol there and construct it as you unify your hearts and your home and your hands, one with another.
Power
God for the giftedness of Brother Brian Courtney Wilson. To God be the glory. Symbols all about us. We've seen them. We've received them. We've acknowledged them. All wonderful symbols. Light. Symbols of rings. We've seen symbols of friends, family, loved ones. Unity candle was just lighted, symbolizing the families from which these two persons have come, the family that they now merge into, become, blend as one. Symbols are all about us. I hold now the greatest of all the symbols that we could possibly experience tonight. These symbols remind us of a love that is far greater than the love these two individuals have for one another. A love that is stronger, deeper. A love that is more profound than anything these two could profess to one another in this sanctuary tonight. For God commended his love toward us, and that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Today we celebrate the fact that we have a Savior who loved us enough give his life as a ransom for us, to redeem us from our sins and to give us new life in him, a life that is both abundant and everlasting. Today we celebrate the fact that these two individuals have everlasting life in Jesus Christ. And we celebrate the fact that the abundant life they've already experienced will be exponentially better now that they've joined themselves one to another. Thank God for Jesus. Thank God for the sacrifice at Calvary. Thank God for new life in Jesus Christ. And as we come together this evening to commemorate what these two individuals now blend as husband and wife into one life together, we thank God for that one life that saved so many lives so many years ago. On a hill called Calvary, a man named Jesus died so that we might live. And today we celebrate that. And we take these elements of the Lord's body and blood. And as these two individuals receive them, they recognize and remember afresh that although they love each other greatly, the love that the Lord Jesus has for them is so much greater than the love that they have for one another. So, Ree, won't you take this element of bread, remembering that the Lord Jesus was wounded for your transgressions, bruised for your iniquity, the chastisement of his peace was upon you. Well, the chastisement of our peace was upon him. And with his stripes, we are healed. Lakeisha, take this symbol of the broken, bruised, battered body of Jesus Christ. And as you remember how much he loves you, won't you eat the bread together? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. What can wash away my sin? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make me whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. How we celebrate that blood tonight that still cleanses from all of our sin. Each of us has to recognize that we have offended the heart of God. But because of the love of Jesus Christ, he shed his blood so that our sins might be covered and cleansed. And as you remember that, as husband and wife, as individuals who have relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ, Lakeisha, Ree, won't you take of the fruit of the vine and drink together in communion? Amen. And all God's people said amen. Come now to the conclusion of our time together. Yes. Did everybody see that? Did you see that? Man put chapstick on his lips to make ready for the moment that is to come. You ready, huh? Well, just before, let me talk to the people for a little while. Let me talk to you. How you doing? You doing all right? It's good to see you on a Friday night. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. What you doing after this? What you got going on? Will you please now rise from that kneeling bench? Once again, facing me. And as much as these two individuals have come into this place, this sacred space, to pledge their lives, their love, their loyalty each to the other, they've done so by exchanging vows and rings. They've done so flanked by friends and family, loved ones all about them. They've done so by communing one with another and with God. It is my absolute delight, my pleasure, my privilege, my honor to pronounce that they are husband and wife in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Ghost. Amen. 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 They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength, mount up with wings as eagles, run and not be weary, walk and not faint. Wait on the Lord. Be of good courage. He will strengthen thine heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord. Mr. Reed, you may now salute your bride. If you get nothing else from Lakeisha Barnett, you get drama. And we thank God for it. And that's the last time I'll use that name. Look this way, let me bless you. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift the light of his countenance upon you and give you his peace. Today, tomorrow, and forever, all the days of your lives. In Jesus' name, amen. 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 Hallelujah. My joy. My joy. Praise the Lord. Love you. Praise the Lord. In just a moment, these two individuals are going to remember our ancestors. Our ancestors who did not have the privilege of such lavish and gorgeous spaces such as these, to signify their union one with another, they would simply jump the broom. And when they would jump the broom, the entirety of the community would recognize that they were officially husband and wife. Ladies and gentlemen, these two shall now descend this platform, and as they do that, they will jump that broom, and then they will officially be Mr. and Mrs. Rev. Dr. Ree and Lakeisha. I said I was going to get this right. My child asked me, had I practiced the name? And I said, yes. Atuquefio is the name. I got this. Mr. and Mrs. Atuquefio in just one moment. Married now.
Call me Simba, Simba. Body enemy, but you let her come out though. See, I'm falling for you. Her backside be safe, so I know if it take left for us. This window. Call it what you want. I can just do what you need. If you give your heart to me, you see we're meant to be. them. You see them where you post the photo. The way you did walk out. I just want to say I go fuck out. But it make man them they suffer. Me, I don't want to.